So, hi, Mia Close, thank you for taking time to chat to us at TBFM.
No worries.
You've just done, this is your first Hard Rock Hell, isn't it?
No, well, it's our first Hard Rock Hell, but it's our second Hard Rock Hell in terms of Hard Rock Hell AOR.
Ah, of course, yeah. Yes. So you played at the AOR this year?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how did you feel the set went? Obviously, I came down to see you. I saw the technical difficulties that you had.
Yeah.
But overall, how do you think the set went?
I think it went really well, considered the power cut.
Yeah.
And I broke two strings as well.
Yeah.
You broke two strings.
Considered everything, I think it went as good as it could have possibly been.
Yeah.
And the crowd was amazing.
It was a good crowd.
Very good crowd.
So what happened? You were partway through a song, and the power goes, the lights go, and the people are sort of having to move closer to hear you, which is nice because you get a bit more of the crowd. And I think it was good timing to have the Skid Row song come in because people could sing along to that, and it was nice to hear that.
Definitely, we worked it out that way. In case there is a power cut, have it in the song before the Skid Row, and you know, worked out pretty well.
It was all planned.
Yeah, it was actually planned. We asked them to have a power cut in that song.
Yeah, it's all planned out. We probably shouldn't tell them that it's all planned out. We want to look like it was spontaneous.
Damn. Oh, okay. Can we just cut there?
No, it was fine. We just thought, okay, let's just play louder, and that's what we did. And everyone seemed to enjoy it still. So
yeah, definitely,
it went all right.
They said Martin, one of the organizers, said that it has happened twice in the history of Hard Rock Hell. Once when Sebastian Bach performed, and now twice when Mia Close performed.
Oh, there you go.
If it's good enough for Sebastian, it's good enough for us.
There you go, and the perfect song, of course, for the power.
Yeah, that's true as well.
A bit of a link there.
Yeah.
Oh, excellent. So so you played AOR before. This is your first Hard Rock Hell. You also played Bloodstock, I think, this year.
Yeah, right? And Sweden Rock.
And Sweden Rock, yeah. Yes. That was a competition.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Thanks to everybody who voted, if there was someone looking.
Excellent. Yeah, we were aware of that competition and pushing, you know, for people.
Yeah,
to vote.
Thank
a lot
you
of
so much.
Bands.
Yeah.
So I think it was hard people to choose, but obviously,
yeah,
brilliant result.
It was a dream come true for me because I've been to that festival so many times when I was younger. So.
Yep. So that was possibly something you were aspiring to do, hit that stage.
Yeah.
Is there any other sort of big stages, big gigs that you'd like to try and get on?
Yeah, well, I mean, they asked us in our interview just earlier now, what is the next dream come true, and I said probably Wacken would be my next dream come true in terms of a gig, because I've always wanted to play in Germany, and I've never so far, so, and it's like, I think it's the biggest festival in Europe as well, so that's a dream come true for me. And then you can say your dream yourself.
Because I grew up in England, I've been to Download a bunch of times, so that would be my dream, to play Download. So yeah, fingers crossed, at some point we'll get to do it.
Yeah, definitely. Mm. That would be a good one. Mm. So do you live in London, or because you're from Sweden, aren't you?
Yeah,
you don't live in Sweden now?
No, I'm from Sweden, but I've lived in London for a few years now, and that's my home.
Okay.
Now it is my home. I mean, I'm going home to Sweden, but got my base in London.
Mm-hmm. And you're from London?
Yeah. Well, it's quite handy. Like, we all live quite close together in the band, which is quite rare in London. Normally everyone's, you know, scattered around miles and miles away. But we all live in a quite close area, which makes life easier for us.
Yeah.
Which is good.
Definitely. So what the London scene is probably a bit better than the rest of the UK in terms of getting people to gigs.
Well, they say that. I mean, of course there is more people in London, but because there is so much going on in London all the time, it's gigs on every night, I feel that the crowd in the rest of the UK, like the further up north you go, the more excited the crowd is, and it's when you go there, they all come to see you.
Yeah.
I mean, we played quite a few times in London. We have our regulars, but you know, because you know, there's so much going on in London, and we play there a few times. It's I find the further up north you go, the better crowd, actually. Oh. Sorry, London.
But the fun thing about being in London is there's loads of other bands, there's loads of other musicians, and everyone is always very supportive of all the other bands. And
yeah.
We've got lots of friends in other bands who we love, so it's really great to have that there. You know?
Yeah, definitely.
Well, I love playing in London too, of course, but I find it, obviously, because I haven't been that much in the rest of the UK, I find it exciting to see new places and new venues.
Yeah, definitely. So your debut album is called London.
Yeah.
So named after your now hometown.
Yes.
Any other sort of stories to why you chose to call the album that?
Well, the album has got a lot of red threads, but the one leading it, tying it all together, is the fact that all the songs are about feelings I've had in London, people I've met in London, places I've been to in London. And what ties it together is the city, so yeah. That's why I choose the name London.
That makes sense. And I believe you've got some new material that's kind of almost ready to go on an album. Are you working on another album right
now? Yeah, we've been working on songs for a new album, but it's been stuff going on constant. This whole year has just been so many exciting things happening. I mean, we had Hard Rock LAOR that we were, you know, focusing on. Then we got Sweden Rock straight after. Then we had Bloodstock straight after. Now we had this performance to focus on. So now when all of these big gigs have been done, now is the time to really focus on writing even more material and like tying all the half-written material together. And then we're going to record and release a single as soon as possible now in the new year, so probably sometime in January or February. And there will be a music video for that single as well.
Excellent.
Yeah, so we're doing a lot of writing around Christmas. We should do a Christmas song.
Yeah.
Next year.
That's true. We should do.
That'd be a good idea.
We should drink some Swedish glögg. Have you drank that?
No.
Have you?
No.
It's like warm wine with like cinnamon and spices and raisins and almonds.
It sounds Christmassy.
It's very Swedish. Mm. Smells lovely.
It sounds lovely.
I'll make some for you guys in the band.
Also, I noticed you've got a calendar coming out next year. Is that something new, or is that something you've always
It's out now.
Oh, it's like, well,
You can buy it at store.miaclothes.com.
Excellent.
Yeah, it's just you know, something that I thought would be a great Christmas present for people who want to buy something rock and roll.
Yeah.
And also, I mean, as everybody knows, the artists are struggling with getting in cash, and I thought, you know, it's a good thing for people to buy, and then we can hopefully, you know, get some money so we can go out and play for more people.
Yeah.
Later.
Yeah. You don't tend to see many bands sort of doing that these days with calendars, unless you're like Metallica or something. I don't even know if they do one. So for a sort of smaller band to try that out, and you know, it'd be interesting to see how it works.
Yeah, we've sold quite a few already, so it's working out well.
Oh, that's really good.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, thank you for chatting to us.
Thank you.
Are you staying for the rest of the weekend, or have you got to head off?
We're leaving tomorrow, so we are doing more interviews and hopefully catching some other bands as well.
Is there any bands you'd like to particularly catch? Or?
Yeah, I would love to see Michael Monroe, but I think we're leaving before his set tomorrow. But I hope I will get to meet him, maybe even in here in the media room.
You never know. Hang around and see who you can find.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah, we're going to try and catch States of Panic as well.
Mm-hmm.
We played with them before, and they're good guys, so hopefully we'll get to check them out.
Yes, definitely.
Excellent. All right, well, enjoy your weekend.
Thank you.
Thank you for chatting to us.
Thank you.
Thank you.